Good morning, dear students. Today we will solve freedom integral equation with the help of iterative kernel and resolvent kernel. Okay, in our previous lecture we already learned about the iterative kernel and resolvent kernel. This is the question: solve yx equal to x plus 0 to 1 upon 2 yt and dt. First we compare this question with the freedom integral equation, general rule of freedom integral equation. So by the comparison we can observe that fx equal to x, lambda is 1, this is the eigenvalue, and k of x comma t is 1, and the limit a to b is 0 and b is 1 upon 2. Okay, kn of x comma t is iterative kernel, and we know about the iterative kernel, the k1 x comma t equal to k of x comma t equal to 1. For finding the k2 x comma t, we can use the formula a to b of k of x comma z plus kn minus 1 z comma tn dz, because the n is 2, so we can n minus 1 is 1, k of x comma z, k1 of z comma tn dz, and both values 1 and 1, the integration of dz is z, and after solving this is 1 upon 2. Similarly for k3 x and t, it is equal to 0 to 1 upon 2, and this value is k of x comma z is 1, and this is 1 upon 2 and dz. Again it is equal to 1 upon 2 is common, and the integration of z with respect to this is 1 upon 2, and this is equal to 1 upon 2 to the power 2. By the induction method and by the observation, when k1, then this is, we can write 1 is 1 upon 2 to the power 0. Okay, when k1, then this power is 0. When k2, then this power is 1. When k3, then this power is 2. Similarly, when k n x comma t, then this power is 1 upon 2 to the power n minus 1. Okay, this is the iterative kernel for this kernel. And for finding the resolvent kernel, we have know about the k of x, t and lambda. It is equal to sum of, we know about the resolvent kernel, it is equal to sum of n equal to 1 to infinity, lambda to the power n minus 1 and k n x comma t and dt, k of x comma t. Okay, we know about the resolvent kernel, then we have the lambda equal to 1, so 1 to the power something is 1, and this value is 1 upon 2 to the power n minus 1. So it is equal to sum of n equal to 1 to infinity, this is 1 to infinity, and this is 1 upon 2 to the power n minus 1. Okay, when we expand this sequence, then this is when we put n equal to 1, then this is 1 upon 2 to the power 0 is 1, plus 1 upon 2, plus 1 upon 2 to the power 2, plus 1 upon 2 to the power 3, and plus so on. This is a geometric series with the common ratio is 1 upon 2. So the sum of this series is, we know about the sum of the series is 1 upon 1 minus common ratio is 1 upon 2. After solving this, we have 2 upon 2 minus 1, and it is equal to 2. Okay, so the resolvent kernel for this is equal to 2, and the answer of this question is, with the help of resolvent kernel of it and iterative kernel, is the answer is yx equal to, the answer is yx equal to fx plus integration of yx equal to fx into lambda 0 to 1 upon 2, and resolvent kernel r of x t and lambda ft and dt. This is the answer of this question, and we have the value of the fx equal to x. We have the value of this is x, fx equal to x plus lambda is 1, and then integration 1 upon 2, resolvent kernel is 2. The resolvent kernel is 2, ft, because fx equal to x, so we can replace x by t, then ft equal to t, this is t and dt. Okay, and after solving this, this is equal to fx equal to, this is x, okay, integration of this is 2 and t square upon 2, and the limit is 1 upon 2. Okay, we can understand it, 1 upon 2. And the answer of this question is fx equal to x plus 2 plus 2, and we can take 1 upon 2 is common, 1 upon 2, this is t square to the power 1 upon 2, t square to the power 1 upon 2 minus 0 after using the limit, then this is the 1 upon 2 to the power 2, and it is equal to x plus 1 upon 4. The answer of this question is x plus 1 upon 4. This is the process for of solving the freedom integral equation. Using iterative kernel and resolvent kernel. Okay, thank you.